Have you heard of neurofeedback and wondered what it was, how it works, and how it could possibly help you? I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, and I want to share those things with you in this video. When I first learned about neurofeedback a very long time ago, I was a skeptic too. And people tell me all the time, I'm a skeptic. And I like to say back to them, that's great, because I love a good skeptic. So I also want to share with you in this video how I use neurofeedback, which is very different than many other neurofeedback practitioners, and how I use data, measurable data, to show you how your brain is changing and improving. But first, let's start with, what is neurofeedback? Neurofeedback is a non-invasive treatment methodology that basically teaches and encourages your brain to use a healthier brain performance pattern, which leads us to, what is a brain performance pattern? A brain performance pattern is the way that your brain is using different brain waves. Brain waves are the different frequencies of electrical energy in your brain. And I smile because it made me think of a joke, which I will tell you before we wrap up. So the idea is, these brain waves, they exist on different frequencies. And typically I try to break them down into three different categories just to make it easier. There's the category of gassing in the brain, which is the faster speed that helps you to focus and helps you to act or react when something stressful happens in your life, gassing in the brain. We also have medium speeds of calm that help you to shift into neutral when you want to sit on the couch and enjoy time with your family. You can bring your brain out of gassing and just chill. Then there's braking frequencies in the brain that allow you to feel groggy and sleepy at night and allow you to shift into the sleep cycle so you can get 8 glorious hours of sleep and wake up and do it all again. That's called circadian rhythms. Circadian rhythms is when your brain is using the healthy performance pattern, which allows you to feel calm and focused throughout the day, react to stressful situations in a healthy manner, and then allows you to get restorative and restful sleep at night. So that is the healthy brain performance pattern. I call it the green zone. The reason I call it the green zone is, first of all, we know when you're in the zone, you're using a healthy brain performance pattern. Secondarily, the first step in having neurofeedback as a treatment methodology is to have a QEEG brain map performed. That's the first step for me, at least, because I need the measurable data. What the QEEG brain map does is it identifies how your brain is using these different frequencies, or gassing, braking, or neutral in the brain. This mapping system is like a brain scan that can tell the magnitude or the amplitude of how much of each of these speeds are being used in your brain in every single area at baseline. QEG brain mapping is very involved, and it's difficult to, all this stuff, it's difficult to explain, but essentially what happens is, when you perform your own QEG brain map at home, then it becomes uploaded into my provider portal and I'm able to review it. The map that I see is comparing your brain against an optimal brain performance pattern, the green zone, and showing me how far away your brain is, or the gap between the green zone and what your brain is doing in terms of using brain waves. It's highly informative. Now, the coolest part of the brain map is, we know that scientifically, many mental and physical health disorders, and I'll share a few of them with you in a minute, mental and physical problems that people struggle or suffer with are due to irregular or dysfunctional brain performance patterns on QEEG brain mapping. Because I am who I am, and I chuckle, I'm a scientist at heart. A scientist and an educator, that's why I'm here. But the scientist in me has reviewed many, if not most, of the scientific articles that exist on these different QEEG brain map patterns. So I definitively know the brain patterns that are behind depression, behind anxiety, behind addiction, behind ADHD or attention issues. there's brain patterns that are at the core of essentially all neurodevelopmental and neurodegenerative disorders. Neurodevelopmental would be speech and language issues, motor issues, learning challenges, behavioral difficulties. Those are neurodevelopmental disorders that happen in the mind and the body because of an irregular brain performance pattern. On the other side of the continuum, we have neurodegenerative disorders like Alzheimer's, dementia, Parkinson's disease, motor disorders, ALS. Those disorders happen because the brain pattern is becoming dysfunctional due to aging or illness. We know that many people struggle with what's called autonomic nervous system dysfunction because of toxins, whether that be toxins in food or in air, or in behavioral toxins like explicit matter and internet addictions. So these dysfunctional brain patterns can be measured and viewed, and I share them with you. What we do is, once you take your brain map at home, then we review it on a Zoom. I share my screen. I walk you through the whole thing. I show you the dysfunctional patterns in your brain and how they relate to your history and what you're experiencing currently. So then from there, once we know what your brain is doing, I'm able to make a treatment plan moving forward. And this is what all neurofeedback providers should do. Measure your brain, see how it's performing, see where the gaps are between your brain performance pattern and the optimal green zone, and then make a plan to close that gap. Now, how does neurofeedback work? Neurofeedback closes that gap through workouts for the brain. That's why I call it brain training. It's completely non-invasive. It doesn't put anything into your brain. It teaches your brain to make less of the dysfunctional pattern and more of the healthy brain performance pattern, the green zone. How could it possibly do that? This is the answer for the skeptics. It does it just like physical workouts do for the muscles in your body. So if you want your muscles to get bigger, you want to create a healthy lifestyle. We'll come back to that in a second. But most importantly, you have to hit the gym and very intentionally give your muscles feedback by using weights that guide the muscle into the healthier, stronger pattern. So I always use an analogy of bicep curls. If you want to get stronger biceps, you have to go to the gym, get yourself a 10-pound weight, and rep out the 10 pounds. And you have to keep going back to the gym until the 10-pound weight is no longer heavy enough and your muscles are feeling stronger. Then you swap out your 10-pound weights for 20-pound weights and you keep repping out the bicep curls. You don't have to say to your bicep, "Come on, bicep, get bigger." You don't even have to think about your workout. There's no thinking involved. There's just the repping out of the bicep curls. Brain training using neurofeedback works in the same way. The way that I offer it, we use this advanced state-of-the-art headband, which it comes with its own software, but then if you work with me, there's highly specialized professional software that I use. And this headband has sensors in it, and it also has a port where we can plug in another sensor to take your brain map. Then, after we have your brain map, this is the technology that you use with the special professional software that I set exactly for the workout that your brain needs. And there are systematically different brain patterns, but of course everybody's brain is different. So what is the underpinning of why neurofeedback works? Neurofeedback works because of neuroplasticity. Neuroplasticity banks on something called Hebb's Law. Hebb's Law states that neurons that fire together wire together. Anti-Hebbian learning states that when you stop firing those neurons together, those patterns will dissipate. So essentially, when you work with me using neurofeedback, we are training your brain to use healthier neural pathways through consistent workouts, and we are training your brain to unwire those pathways that you've been using for a long time or for a lifetime. So this workout essentially makes the muscle of your brain stronger the way that it uses brain waves and the electrical energy in your brain. So what happens after the workouts? We use the professional software. In my program, it's a 4-month program to get started, but we're always analyzing the data. The professional system that I use is amazing. It gives me so much data. Every session that you do at home, I get tons of data that I also string together so I can see how your brain is performing within and across sessions. So you always know through data where your brain started, where your brain is on any given day, and how close you are to the optimal pattern. And so we're doing the workouts. The system is automatically thresholding, meaning it's automatically swapping out the weights for you, but I individualize the program and I will change your protocols. I can change your sites. I make sure that I'm pushing you forward, just like your personal trainer would if you went to the gym, at the just right push. Not too much, but also fast enough so you can see these changes show up for you. The idea is, once you get your brain in a healthy spot, then you can ease off the personal training and you can ease off the professional software. But I show you how to use this headband long term, so you know how to do your workouts at home for the rest of your life. Is it necessary? No. Is it recommended? Absolutely. I use this headband multiple times a week. I actually use it almost every day, but that's because I love neurofeedback. It changed my life. It changed my family's life, which is why neurofeedback is the only neurotherapy that I offer. When I started my own practice many moons ago, it was after decades of being a college professor, where I learned how to use every neurotherapy that's out there. I was certified in every single type. Anything else you've heard of, I'm basically probably certified in it. And the idea is, I bought all those things and I incorporated it into my practice when I left the university. And slowly over time, other neurotherapies kept coming off the table. And before you know it, neurofeedback is the only neurotherapy that I offer and I have offered for over a decade. And the reason being is, it gives you the biggest bang for your buck. We're regulating and healing those dysfunctional brain patterns at the level of your brain using your brain. The other therapies would essentially use your mind and your body, or they just weren't as powerful of regulating and adjusting the brain waves. This is what I find is the way that I can help people the fastest and the easiest for them to be able to decrease symptoms and create the life that they want to. So when I found neurofeedback, it found me, and I left those other neurotherapies. Honestly, I left them in a closet for a decade, but I left them by the wayside and they're not something that I practice anymore. So let's move on to, who is neurofeedback a great idea for? This is a great idea for you if you've tried medications and they are not working for you. It's a great idea for you if you don't want to use anything that's invasive. Invasive means you're putting something into your nervous system or your body. You don't want to do that. Neurofeedback's great for you. If you want more information on neurofeedback, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. I have many blog posts that describe neurofeedback, and there's a few web pages that show you how I offer neurofeedback. It's easier than ever to enjoy neurofeedback and to get the benefits at home, and the data will prove to you that your brain is changing, your brain is improving, and you will be able to get the desired results if you heal your brain. Okay, so how does one brain say goodbye to another? With a brainwave. And with that, control your brain or it'll control you. I'll see you next time.